It's my dream. It's my dream.
It's my dream.
I think I got into this sport at the worst time possible, which is probably also the best time possible because it's the most challenging. I mean, I think I've been going at it strong now for like 6 years. I grew up in the suburbs of Portland, Oregon, played stick and ball sports like most kids, and I remember one day sitting out the outfield of the Alpenrose Dairy. So there's a little quarter midget go-kart track right near the outfield, and you just heard him go around and around and around, and I just thought to myself, man, I want to do that. I want to do that. I don't know what it was. Maybe it was the sound or the image of race cars in my head. My dad, he worked for a company that would give us tickets to go to the racetrack. I remember meeting like Mario Andretti and Michael Andretti and getting autographs and then watching them drive by me on the track and walk over the bridge at Portland International Raceway and feel the cars go under you. That moment was it for me. I was 18 years old, going to music business school, living in Los Angeles, California, working for Snoop Dogg at Doggy Style Records, and I knew it really wasn't what I wanted to do, and I still didn't have any friends or family in the industry, no connections there, and I figured I just had to figure it out on my own. So I started selling real estate, made enough money to build a race car, and had no idea what I was doing, and went out racing. I remember the first race, it was pouring down rain, 45 degrees out. I didn't even have rain tires.
My wife quit her job at one of the best ad agencies in the country. We sold our house and moved to Charlotte, North Carolina, aka Race City, USA, where I do not fit in, and started racing at the Short Tracks of America, NASCAR Home Track Series, late model stock car racing. So it's fiberglass steel cage bodies with 500 horsepower engines and half mile ovals that are like old as you can. I mean, they were like the first NASCAR tracks. Some days are tough and sometimes you kind of forget the dream, especially when you're working within the industry. Sometimes you realize maybe that dream you had isn't really what you thought it was, and you kind of question yourself, do I really want this? But at the end of the day, I can get back in a crappy go-kart and I realize right then what I want and why I want it.
6 years later, I'm still grinding, I'm still working really hard, I work in the industry, and I definitely am going to be a professional race car driver. It's my dream and it's going to happen. So.